this is part of our holiday festivities, and we are going to take on a cookie dough making competition. So we've kind of cheated a little bit, because Mark is making cookies that have oatmeal and chocolate chips and stuff in them.
Oatmeal, chocolate chip, and almonds.
Right.
Or almonds, as we call them in Northern California.
And I'm just doing regular chocolate chip cookies, because that works for me. And so we had to divide our ingredients fairly. So we've kind of come up with our own little situations on how to do that. We both have to actually measure our vanilla, and we both have to crack eggs. So that's our little, you know, extra in there. But and so we're going to see who makes actual full-on cookie dough first. That's all.
Who do you think will win?
So, here we go. Ready?
Are you ready to go?
No, hold on.
Okay. Rearrange your stuff. It's all nice and laid out.
Okay.
A little whiskey in my cookie.
Oh, yeah, he's got that as an extra. But my butter's melted, so that's an advantage. Okay.
Okay.
Ready?
Blow the whistle.
1, 2, 3, go!
And soft. How's yours?
Good. I did my ingredients wrong, though. I put them in the wrong order. Oops! I should have put the sugar in first.
Oh, sugar first. Sugar and butter. Oh, yeah. I'll do a little bit of that. Still rolling. We got it on tape.
Oh, I don't care about winning or losing. I'm not competitive. But I just, I'm seeing that, like, I'm still got some flour in there, you know. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. See what I'm talking about?
I need to make some more.
You want me?
I will have no hesitation to admit when I'm wrong. At all. But I'm never wrong, so. We're not eating the dough. No, not at all. Mm-hmm. Organic bed. It's all good.
Good dough. Okay, oven is preheated.
You can watch me in here.
There you go. Okay, so I got busted. I forgot to put in the whiskey. So
see?
She wins by default because I didn't really use all my ingredients.
My batter totally sucks.
My day's way better.
Mm, yeah, totally. Not that we ate it.
And right. I'm going to add a little more whiskey.
Gonna get drunk on his cookies. These are drunken oatmeal cookies. That's what they are. Whee!
Would you like some of that, darling?
Oh, God, no. Thank you. So, since my batter sucks, I'm gonna use the spoon method to put my cookies together, simply because it gives me the ability to make a shape out of them. Since
very
the butter
nice.
Is not really gonna work so great on that one. Because it was melted. That's what we figured out. The melted butter. Don't start with melted butter.
Don't use melted butter, yes.
I always use softened butter.
Softened butter. And I add the sugar first. And the egg.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And the vanilla.
Mix
and
those
wet
three
ingredients
together first. Yeah. Yeah. And then I added the flour. And
then you add all your dry stuff.
And the nuts and the chocolate chips.
This is important because baking
and
is chemistry.
And oatmeal.
If you don't do it
that's
right,
the best
it doesn't work.
Maybe even good.
Hmm. So what method of cookie rolling do are you doing?
I'm using the hands.
Gonna get his dirty fingers in that dough.
That's right, my dirty, dirty fingers. Let me wash them. Never know.
Ew, germs!
Because they were just in the bowl, mixing the cookie batter.
And we didn't wash our hands first. Oh, we didn't get enough film release.
I'm an obsessive hand washer, so I can't help myself.
We're all a little OCD about something.
Something. 12 categories.
No, I think I'm way more OCD than you are. Or actually, I think maybe we could be the same OCD-ness, except in different areas.
Different areas, yeah. So name your OCD areas.
Like germs and
that?
Stuff.
Germ, okay.
Yeah, like sharing people's drinks and stuff, and I have a real hard time with that.
Okay, well, we share that. I definitely have that, too.
Okay, wait, but you have a different kind of OCD about, like, dogs and, like, the way you like things in your house. But I have an OCD about the house stuff, for sure.
Yeah, is that OCD, though? Or is that just normal, like, personal preference?
I guess what you would say, normal people would say it's OCD, but I just think it's normal.
Who are normal people?
Right, who's normal? What's up with them?
What does that even mean?
And who says that we're supposed to do stuff? Like, why is this supposed to do?
A cookie ball? Hmm? How do your cookie balls?
Well, my cookie balls are pretty good.
That one's looking pretty sloppy right
now. Yeah,
there.
Well, he fell apart a little bit.
Did it? Oh, just kind of exploded right on the sheet.
He did. He had a...
He had a meltdown.
He had a Christmas dough.
He was about to have a meltdown.
Oops, he liked that one. It fell apart.
Oh, these are so good. I want to fit more on the tray so bad.
No, you should only do 12, because if you overcut
them,
they
don't
cook.
No, I'm going to do 12. I'm doing 12. I was only going to do 9, and I'm like, fuck, I got to do 12.
Oh, but no, those are going to be big, though, dude.
I know.
So you could do 9. I don't think you should do 12. Not in that little guy, because he's short. I could do 12 on this one, because it's longer. I like it longer.
No, I don't know if it can pick us up like that. We got to be hoid.
Can you hear us? Can you hear us now?
We had Christmas music on earlier. What happened to that?
Yeah, what happened to that?
I don't know.
Who's going to leave their post?
I guess I better go put that on for a moment.
Sound engineer, coming through.
Nice,
Mark,
so you
got
won that.
Oh, he got 12! Yay!
Look at that. Okay. Beautiful.
Okay, so are we going to put these in the oven together?
Together.
No, but like...
Together.
You ready? I'm talking about
I'll race you.
Do you think there'll be too much heat? I don't know.
I get the bottom, you get the top. How's that? In the oven, 350. Okay, you got your timer? Where's your timer?
Phone's over here.
Timer! What are we doing, 8 minutes, 9 minutes?
No, 9 to 11, so.
9 to 11, so we're gonna check them at 9 minutes.
Timer.
Yeah?
09, start. Timer in process.
In process. Man, we got enough batter for another, well, you got enough batter for an army.
Yeah, man. These will make like 3 dozen cookies. Because you have shrinkage in your dough.
Shrinkage?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
From the oatmeal.
That's it.
Yeah, mine doesn't shrink. It's just
there. You have a lot more, more sugar, too.
Well, yeah, but I'm actually making smaller balls than you are. So. Mm. Oh, hey, speaking of balls, let's show you another way of decking the halls with your balls. We're going to put together some cookie dough to make some Russian tea cakes. And it's a labor-intensive process because it involves rolling them all in powdered sugar. But anyway, that's it next.
Let's do it. Hi.
Hi.
What are you doing?
Well, cookies just came out of the oven.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
And they smell so good. We figure the house will probably smell like this for a couple of days, which is a good thing around the holidays. Always want your house to smell like butter, sugar, and flour during the holidays.
Yeah.
So we thought we'd sit down and have a little taste of our cookies that we've made, the chocolate chip cookies and the oatmeal chocolate chip almond Maker's Mark cookies.
Maker's Mark, yeah. Just
Woo!
A sprinkle of Maker's Mark in there. There you go.
Yeah. So let's start with mine.
Okay.
Because, yeah.
Yeah, well, how about if I taste yours and you taste mine?
Ooh! Okay, so here we go.
Critique.
Oh, man.
Look at that.
See, now that's pretty good for an oatmeal cookie not to fall apart when you try to take it.
And this is a great texture. That's your cookie, too.
Mm-hmm.
Look at that. It's not too dry, but it's crisp.
Chocolate chip cookies should be
good crunch.
Crunchy but chewy. I'm liking this because it's dense, but it has the sweet of the chocolate with the crunchy of the nuts. I like my food with crunchy nuts in it. Ice cream, cookies. It's a good thing.
And I'm liking the simplicity of this cookie because it doesn't have all those ingredients. You taste the butter and the flour. And you really taste that. Luscious part of it with a little chocolate sprinkled in. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I used dark chocolate chips. Did you use dark chocolate chips in here?
Mm-hmm. I did. Yeah.
We're at that point where we like dark chocolate chips better. It'll be fine taste buds, I suppose it would be. But yes, yeah, very good stuff.
Bravo, Marlena.
Yeah, oh, bravo, Marcus. Lovely. All we just need now are 2 really large glasses of milk.
Right.
Cheers to the holidays and good milk to wash down those holiday cookies with.
Indeed. Yeah. Oh, my cookies. Oh, my. They're like lava cookies, huh?
Yeah, they are. No, but they're not hockey pucks, though, and that's a good thing. Because, mm-hmm. you know, they could be hockey pucks, but you kept the moisture in them. Mm. It's good.
Like it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and then that oatmeal hits your tongue and it's like sucks up quick excess moisture.
Yeah.
You gotta dip these.
Mm, yeah.
But yours will be great dippable too, because they'll hold up.
Mm-hmm. So I'd have a cookie hold up with milk, even if it's almond milk. That's pretty tasty.
That's actually almond coconut blend.
Nice. I don't like coconut milk, so that is good. Okay. So as Mark finishes his cookie, I'm going to explain what we're going to do next. We have a recipe here for what I call Russian tea cakes. This is a family recipe. My mother gave it to me. I made them for years and years. And it's basically a ton of butter, some powdered sugar, chopped walnuts, and a lot of flour, like 4 cups of flour. 4 cups of butter, 4 cups of flour in here. So lots of very kind of dry dough. It's not unusual for it to be dry. This has been in the fridge for probably overnight, I think I did. So we're just starting to see it get to room temperature and be workable. So you don't want it totally cold, but you don't want it totally warm either, because this is a butter-based cookie. You're not going to be able to roll these very well if they're too warm, which is why you want to chill it after you make all the dough. You chill it for an hour to 24 hours.
Do you? Yeah.
But these are falling apart, so... this
together.
Year, what I did differently with this recipe, which I was wanting to try, is that I used whole wheat flour instead of enriched bleached white flour. So I'm wondering how that's going to change the texture of these.
Oh, well, that's holding together.
But
did
yeah, it's
that?
Like the warmth of your hand helps the butter melt just right. And then it feels like they're never going to come together, but the butter gets melted just right where it starts to hold up. And that's the whole point. You just want it to hold up enough to get onto the cookie sheet.
And I'm going to wash my hands.
He's going to wash his hands. I already did mine. So these cookies will not spread on the cookie sheet. They will just stay in a little ball. So some people call them snowballs as well. And then after they're done baking, while they're still warm, we roll them in powdered sugar. So, like I said, this is a labor-intensive cookie, but well worth the efforts. This is my favorite holiday cookie ever. So tasty.
Okay, so I just wad it up into a ball.
Yeah, if you want to loosen it a little, you know, with a spoon. Just the first couple of layers, maybe, just to get it
looks like a delicious crumble.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, like if you put this on top of a pie.
Can I just eat it just like this?
Well, yes, it's just a lot of butter and sugar. I'm not sure you want to without the powdered sugar. But.
How much? Okay, I see your balls there.
So yeah, 1 inch is what they say for the size.
1 inch bowls.
I kind of start making them a little bigger, and then as they come together in your hand and you're squishing them, the crumbs drop off, and so they become smaller. So yeah, I'm making it kind of large.
There's my
like a
first
fish.
Bowl.
Hey!
Did that come together?
Yeah, it looks good.
Look at all the crumbs. The crumbs together.
They are crummy. Crummy cookies.
Crummy.
Crumbly crummy cookies. Okay. So we're just going to keep doing this.
Yeah.
It's kind of nice. It's like a meditation for your hands. Because you know how they have those like meditation balls? The silver ones that go bling, 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 when you do that in your hand. It's kind of like, it feels that way because you're squeezing this dough to make it into a little ball. And, you know, the massage of your hand is actually kind of nice.
That's
of course,
nice.
In the morning,
that's
you're
going
to wake up with some sore ligaments. Simply because you're going to be rolling these for a while.
Yeah. Us guys are used to that.
Wait, where's my football?
Ooh, that was a tough one.
Oh!
Kind of a misshapen. The ball didn't reach its potential.
Oh.
What kind of nuts did you put in here, Marlena?
No, I used walnuts.
Walnuts?
Mm-hmm. They belong
why
to Walmart.
Why walnuts? Really? Grown in Walmart?
No, I actually got these from Trader Joe's. But
hey, there you go, Trader Joe's, now you're talking.
Yeah,
I
take out my stress relief on nuts too, by the way. When I'm baking, it's really good stress relief. Because here's the thing, they always ask for chopped nuts in cookie recipes. Chomp, well,
yes.
I don't chomp my nuts. I beat the crap out of them.
Oh, wow.
So I put them on my nice granite countertops with like a meat cleaver, but the flat side of it, not the cleaver. What's the meat tenderizer thing?
Oh,
you know, that
hammer. Part, huh?
And then I take the flat part of it, instead, not the pegged part, and put all the nuts in a baggie, like a freezer baggie, so it's a little heftiness to it. Or you could use the same bag that the nuts come in from the store. And I just pound the crap out of them. And it works. So these are pounded nuts. A lot of frustrations to get rid of recently. This is another reason I love the holidays.
Okay. So.
Very practical cookie.
What kind of butter did you use? Is it organic butter? Or imperial margarine?
Oh, hell no. Never put margarines in cookies. Ever. Ever, ever, ever. I will come to your house and change your recipe.
I will come to your house and change your recipe.
I didn't want to say anything.
Sorry,
other than that.
Hearthstone.
But yeah, no, butter is for cookies, not margarine. Margarine or Crisco.
Butter is for cookies.
Crisco is not for cookies.
Crisco
is for pie,
yeah,
crust, and that is it.
We used to use Crisco when I was a kid.
But if you're going
to
use Crisco, you might as well use
taste
good old-fashioned lard.
Like, I put my finger in the Crisco, you know, and I taste it and be like, ew, what is this?
Yeah,
why,
my mom used
why
to
is
this?
Crisco. What you doing now?
Well, this is step two of the Russian tea cake process. They have been baked. They're nice and warm, just out of the oven. And so we take the spoons, and this is a bowl of powdered sugar. And you just kind of toss them around in the powdered sugar. And there you go. Now you want to probably do this process twice, but for video's sake, we'll just do it once. And you know, you kind of knock off the extra snow. This is why people call them snowballs. And so
this why? It looks just like snow.
The first layer of powdered sugar will melt onto the warm cookie. So you have a nice little first layer there.
It melts right onto it like caramelization.
Oops. And then
throw it at me.
The second one is for the extra oomph in your bite of cookie. You get that extra bit of sugar.
Can't wait to eat one of these.
Yeah, no, they're going to be great. You'll be able to do that in like 5 seconds. Just roll another one and you can bite in.
Roll another one. Just like the other one.
You can watch these cookies since they're mostly butter. In the oven, they get... Ooh, you lost yours.
It got buried in the snow. It was like a big snow drift just swallowed it.
Avalanche!
Avalanche. Oh, man,
it's skiing!
It's melting this shit. Oh, excuse me.
It's a sugar!
Kids, don't do this at home.
Parental advisory on this video. But see how messy it gets? It's so much fun. And if you have a dog, they're underneath the table licking the sugar off the floor. It's perfect.
Or her dogs are on top of the table with you.
No.
Oh, look at that. Can I lick the spoon?
No, because you gotta go in for seconds, dude.
Seconds?
Yeah, what are you gonna do?
You're gonna dip them again? Oh, double dipping. Okay.
Double dipping, dude.
Wow. Here we go.
And this is what gets the coat on it for the bite, you know? Like, if you just have one little melted sugar on the outside of the cookie, that's
the
just
first,
no fun.
The first one is kind of baked on there now from the
heat. Yeah, from the heat. Oh!
That is too cool.
And this dough is actually pretty good. I did good with this because, you know, usually when you drop one, it's so crumbly that it'll just crumble and crumble into pieces. And, oh, oops, then you have to eat it.
This is how the Russians do it.
Double sugar.
Damn. I wonder if Trump knows about this.
Ha! This is probably Trump's favorite cookie. Maybe we should call him and find out, huh?
Mr. Call Trump? Him? Who are you going to call? Okay. Yeah, I'd say they're getting a nice, healthy coating.
Sugar.
And then there's a whole mess of sugar on the...
Oh yeah, it happens like that all the time.
Cookie sheet. So
usually,
what did
Well, normally I just put this on wax paper, but we didn't have any wax paper tonight, so.
We ran out of wax paper.
So this is a messy project.
But you are going to bake them again?
No, this is it.
We just
do this, and this is it. The two layers of powdered sugar, and you're done, and then you can eat them.
Oh, now we can eat them.
So, yeah, usually this is a pretty messy project. Wax paper works great because you just fold it all up and throw it in the trash and you're done.
And those, those are unbaked. Okay.
These are unbaked, yeah, we need
so
to
we're
bake
ready
them.
So we're ready to eat now. Can I eat one?
Woohoo,
now?
Yes! Go ahead!
I'm gonna eat this one.
Oh, so they're nice and warm, and sugary, and buttery, and they're snowballs. Yum!
This is Christmas.
What do we think of the wheat flour versus the bleached flour?
Well, I like the wheat flour. I can tell. It's got that nice earthiness to it.
Yeah.
Wheaty earthiness. It's nice.
These are great cookies with tea, actually. You said tea. Tea would be perfect for these. I'm not powerful.
The most dangerous thing is that powdered sugar, like, you inhale while you have one of these on your lips, and you're inhaling powdered sugar, and it's like, it'll make you
your
cough.
Friends will think you just went to the bathroom and didn't want to cough.
That's why people cough when they eat these.
No.
Mm-hmm. But hold your breath when you put it in your mouth.
No, man, I swear it's just powdered sugar, yo.
Those
and then it gets all over you, of course, Joe. These are the messiest to eat, but boy, people love them. There you go.
Well done.
Russian tea cakes. Woo!
Here they are.
Try it for yourself.
Happy holidays. Oh, that was like my last gas performance.
That's all I had left in me.
We just did a great
thing.
We totally missed it. The perils of professional recording. What is this thing doing? It's like swooping back and forth.
Is that? Oh, maybe we wouldn't have gotten it recorded anyway.
Zoomed in.
Zoom not supported in this mode.
Hey, jingle bells.
No, it's not the same. Shit.
It's not the same.
We had this whole thing. It was really funny. Oh, well.
We had this whole thing. Guido.